Welcome everyone. This is the last coloring session for Resonance. She's from Dance Dreams Coloring Book Volume 1 by Christine Ejak, who is me. Today we're listening to Lifescapes, Pure Relaxation, Escape, Unwind, and Reflect. CD from 2000, that's not too bad. To me that seems like yesterday, right? 2000. Drinking today. So I'm trying a new kombucha. This is Brew Doctor Superberry Raspberry Blueberry with oolong tea. It's sparkly and refreshing, and I think it's going to give me a boost this morning. Yeah, it's delicious. I've never tried this brand before. I really like it. Okay, so let's finish it up. We're going to finish the nautilus-y weavy thing here. So I'm gonna take the green first. I'm pretty sure that's what I did first. A little darker along the edges. Makeshift phone stand here for taping. I have to color around it. So you'll see my hand changes a little bit here to get around my stand. I'm gonna go over that sunray. Okay, and I'm gonna take one of our blue turquoisey colors. Darken the line and come a little bit from the corners up. The same thing up here, I'm gonna darken that little dip. And here's where that U that we've talked about comes in line. So the U shadow makes these shapes grounded. Go as dark or as light as you want to create that illusion that this is like a braided rope. Boy, the birds are really singing this morning. You're trying to compete with the construction guys next door. Alrighty. And a little bit, I go in with my circles and pull a little bit of dark blue in there. Can even maybe go darker then too. Looks like the green is gonna go up in here too. I usually don't use that much green, but I like it this time. Touches it up over here and here. So, we had done this gray over here, You could keep going with this green around, or you could echo the gray, which is what I'm gonna do, but I think I'm gonna wait and do one more layer of green before I switch over to that gray. This is the more bluish gray that I had found after the fact. Go right over that. That was a pencil hitting the ground. Did you hear that? That's how they break. I'm gonna take that swish and just take it right through. And this one too. I'm gonna make it blue. Press a little bit harder. And this one as well. I'm gonna make it blue. These could be any color. They could come from the center and be yellow. Soup them up and make them purplish yet. I think I might do that just for fun. Where's my purples? Okay, I'm just doing this to add a little bit of contrast. So if you wanted to echo some of those lines so it looks like it's a little see-through. Yeah, that works for me. I'm gonna bring this darker purple in here, I think. So it looks like it's wrapped around. I'm gonna make this more like a flower than a leaf. An idea. So I think I liked that it kind of picked up from that purple there. I'm gonna go softer in here. A little bit. And I'm going to get one of my more lavendery blues. Inspired by one of my hibiscus that just opened. Actually, it's not. I think it's not a hibiscus. Maybe it is. Ukrainian, it's malve. It's like, yeah, I think it's of that family. I planted it last year and they were so tiny. They have the most beautiful purple flowers with a lavender blue. blue inside. And they started blooming. I'm so excited. You know, because sometimes perennials don't come back. And you wonder what you did wrong. Pressing pretty hard actually to create that, and it's gonna come here. I'm just trying to create a continuation of that stem flowing through there a little bit. And in the center of that, interesting. That works. So I'm going to do the same kind of coloring with this one up here. You can have fun with these seeds. It can be any color that, any color you like, really. So I'm just trying to play around here and see what I like. Same time, pulling in all the other colors. I just noticed this could use a little bit of a punch. All those yellows could use a little bit. Zooming. Green. Yeah, so I think you could go through with all of this and add yellows and brighten it up, make it a little more intense, if you wanted to. Seems to me like it's a little too pastel-y. Could use a little more zing. And a fuchsia color. That's not it. Where's my favorite one that's so tiny? See it anymore. My favorite fuchsia. Oh, very similar to the other one. Maybe too similar. And I'm not even sure what color to put in the center of that. Maybe this one? So when you want to shade something that's circular, you do like a C, and then you're gonna have like a circle here, and that creates that volume there. So the light's coming from that side. We can do the same C. It's gonna be a little trickier because it's so tiny. Touch this one with a little bit of blue, maybe. those don't pop as much, but those colors, I'm gonna do them yellow. I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna take the rosy colors that I have. So they're like overlapping shapes. You can pick which ones you want to be what. They could be all different. Like little rows, that's kind of neat. So these dots all here, I think oranges and yellows are good because they really stand out. So I'm going real dark on the outside edge so it looks like a bubble. If a couple of these were lime green, I think that would be good too. So they really look like seeds. These look actually like baby rosies, so I'm gonna go back in with them. Inside edge, and I'm doing that blue in the center. Because we're so close to the yellow, I don't know, maybe we should make these ones some more green. So I took a little bit, this is the like a turquoisey blue. Waiting to come out in the world. And I wanted to take this one out a little bit yellow. This one too. Alrighty, so we moved a little touch of yellow here. Just a little bit on that outside edge. So this is all optional. This is the fine tuning. This is just what my eye sees. To soup up a little bit. Okay, so now we get to go to her. Oh my goodness, I think I need to take a sip of something and decide. So I think I'm going to make my girl maybe orange into like this color reds, or oh gosh, now I don't even know. Because, you know, I love fuchsia, and she also could be just like one of these petals coming out. I know what my friend is going to color her, my friend that loves yellow. I have no doubt. I think I'm going to keep her in the pink range, and pinks and fuchsias. So, just have some fun here. I just had this fear that I didn't hit play, but I did, so we're good. So I'm gonna start with her little bit of her backside here showing, and that's gonna be pretty dark. Although, because it's closer to that sunshine, it might be brighter, but I start from under her arm there. Now there's all these patterns in here. You can choose to color over them. Use them as your guide. I'm going to use it as a guide. So this design comes up here and there's a couple little dots. And then this one kind of here. So I'm just darkening with my pencil all those little squiggles. I'm going to come up against it here. Leafy shape and little squiggles and bubbles. I like imagining that she's kind of tattooed with the universe's energy. Morph her into another color. So I'm just going to go down just a little bit with this purple. And then in here it's going to be darker because that's the inside of her leg hiding here. And there's this spiral lines. Another spiral around her leg here. A couple more bubbles. So just by pressing, you know, harder, you can accent those things. Under her instep is gonna be a little darker. I am going to outline her with my pencil. Question is, how far do I want this to go? I think maybe up this one shoulder. Do I want her skin to take on the purple? You know, I don't know. I think I'm kind of just drawing by the seat of my leotard right now. Just made a joke. Okay, and then I'm going to use that pretty lavender blue that I really like. This one here. Same thing, I'm going to kind of just touch those shapes. If you could get a tattoo, what would you get? I've thought about it a couple of times. I don't know. So in Ukrainian, in the area where the Ukrainians are, there was this, you think the Amazon women, the warriors, are in that area. And they found burial sites and the women were buried with their weapons, and they were obviously like almost like chiefs, you know, and they weren't petite, and their bodies are covered in tattoos. beautiful tattoos. Symbol be. Somebody did a past life regression thing on me and they said that I had a shield with crossed arrows and a sparrow on my shield. I think that's kind of interesting. Or like a lark kind of bird, I guess. Oh, a swallow. Yeah, it was a swallow and crossed arrows. That's cool. All right, so she's got a really neat necklace on. Your face, it's darker to lighter here, darker in that eye, darker under the nose, chin is a little rounded, little triangle there, so I'm making her blue. There's going to be a triangle right here down from the eye corners and above her cheekbone. Just gives her some dimension. I kind of like her not of this world. My mom would tell me she looks like she has rigor mortis whenever she sees someone with that colored nail polish. I think she's like an avatar. Why not? Blue's a beautiful color, right? Can blend into the sky and the water easily. I'm gonna take this purple in. Just touch her, her leg a little bit. That's cool. Okay, so now I'm going to take one of the deeper blue colors. Let's see, what do I got here? Oh, this is that one I really like. I feel like I need to give her at least a little pink lips. Let me see. That's good. Okay, so I'm going to take this blue and just go under her leg and try to give her a little bit more dimension. So her thumb will be a little darker in there, and those fingers that are behind. And I'm just going right over the line. It's there. A bit darker here. So you see, I went up from that point, I filled this in darker, and then you go up a little bit that way, and that makes her thigh look a little rounded. A little bit under there. You can go a little darker into her foot right here, so she gets an arch. See how she's popping out now? I'm gonna shade in just a little bit more of her torso. A little darker under the armpit here. And around. A little darker right here where the neck and the shoulder meet. That are in back. She kind of. Oh boy, what was that? Darn it, that was a CD. I'm dropping things today, it's not good. Darken. You ever have a day like that? I was breaking glass last week. I broke a mirror the other week. Before that, I was like, oh boy, what's going on? I'm gonna do just a little bit of that leotard because I like that shape. So now she's starting to dance off of her background there. Oh, this is exciting. All right, using that same dark blue, gonna go over here and try to pull. Now this is, you know, me, you don't have to do this, but I like to maintain a little bit more. You could also use a purple over here if you wanted to. It was just calling out to me that it needed a little bit of intensity over here. I'd like to pull out some of those shapes. I could also use another, just a darker red, like a burgundy color. And I think I'm gonna go into here too. See how this works. Just from that edge. A little bit of a pattern. That worked good there. And darker in there. This is a fun part. The layers make your page look rich, you know? Give you rich and you can pull out. So I don't like to have black lines showing. So this kind of tints them a little, so you see them a little, but they're not necessarily gray, they have some color to them. And I like this blue for that. Like I said, you could just pick a darker green or a darker red, or if you don't like that. Darker behind her. There's those S shapes. or the C shape we talked about. I think I am going to go in here and completely add some more drama down here. I think I like that there. Yeah, that's kind of cool. Everything's going a little deeper. And we can do that up here too, opposite page. Just go on and on and on. And the more you go around with your hand, you'll see things that could be touched and highlighted. And darkened up so that they show a little bit more. Texture coming in. Yes, I like it. And there was one thing. I think the center could use a little bit more, but this is just me. By just doing touches here and there, we create more of a shimmer effect, you know, so it's not like the whole thing, but I'm gonna go over the screen a little bit. Oh, that's kind of cool. So I'm creating a texture. Extending past the it's a little scary, but do you see what it does? It sends it out from the center. Definitely the last step. Sure that it all radiates from the center. It would be good to do that with a yellow. Let's see. I'm gonna be courageous. Oh yeah, here we go. So it's a texture on top. I can't get my hand around up here. Let's see. So it makes it look like this is definitely resonating out. It's kind of fun. It's very subtle. Again, not necessary. But it creates a really neat layer on top of that. And I think with that, I am done. So, the last stitch. Get yourself a pen. Don't
that's okay.
And I'm going to give my John Hancock. I'm going to put it over here. Okay, Ijak. That was fun. I hope you had as good of a time as I did coloring Resonance today. Oops. Yeah, it's fun. And I'll see you next week as we color another page from our book. I think we're getting close to being finished, Volume 1. Thanks, everyone.